Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to yet another video. As you could tell by the title, today we're gonna be reviewing, reviewing, I'm basically just gonna be showing the Bretman Rock collection, the Bretman X Wet n Wild collection. I got it from Walmart. I went to Walmart to buy like stuff I needed, and I ran into it and I was like, you know what, why not? I didn't get everything. I only got the palette, which is like the main part, you know what I mean? I got the palette and I got two brushes. I believe that his collection was three brushes or more. I could totally be wrong. Anyway, not the point. I got two of them and you will see which two that I got. And yeah, that's basically it. We're gonna hop right into the video. And I'm not gonna be using the palette today because I did my makeup for this video. So yeah, we're just gonna keep it like that. And you know what, I feel like this instrumental is very loud, so Lord. Okay, so yeah, as you know, Bretman Rock collabed with Wet n Wild and he came out with like a jungle theme collection. And I believe it was palettes, lip glosses, highlighters, loose highlighter, I believe it was, and brushes. And if there's more, correct me if I'm wrong. I really don't remember. So I'm gonna start off with the two brushes that I got. I don't know the prices of them. Don't ask me, okay? I believe the palette is like 15. One of the brushes, I think this brush is like $6 something. I don't know. But you could look it up on Wet n Wild. I could totally link it up down below. I always say I'm gonna link stuff down below and I never do. So you know what, don't quote me on it. But Wet n Wild website, you could totally check out. We're gonna start off with this brush. So this is the eyeshadow precision blending brush. I'm gonna open it. This is the packaging. It's like I said, jungle theme. It has like flowers, and yeah, it says Bretman Rock X Wet n Wild in like gold lettering. So this is it. This is the brush. It's pink, and I think this is Bretman Rock. Yeah, it sure does say Bretman Rock. And then it's like a gradient effect from gold to pink. I love that because I love pink. And this is the brush. It's like a tapered kind of blending brush. And this is like the perfect brush. I feel like you could complete a makeup look with like multiple of these, just these types of brushes. It's definitely possible. And yeah, I think this is the best type of brush to have. You could get in the crease with them. You could come to your brow bone with it. You could, it might be a little harder, but you could totally pack like shades onto your eyelid with them. Ew, why am I all up in my hair like this? Anyway, you could totally pack eyeshadows with this brush, even though it would be hard. That's why I say you could totally complete a makeup look with like three of these brushes. This is a very good brush to have. Okay, this is an extremely good brush to have. I love it, and super soft. You got to see it. All right, that's one of them. I love the packaging and how they're in these cute little singular things that like cylinder things. Also, it's vegan. They don't test it on animals either. So yeah, next, same packaging. This is the face highlighting brush. Same thing as the first brush. It's the gold into pink gradient effect, and this is the brush. It kind of looks like a bigger version of that same brush I just showed you guys, but it's for highlight right there. And you could tell it's easier like to do a nose versus using like a fan brush, because I use a fan brush to do my highlight sometimes, and sometimes I use like a, I can show you guys, I'll either use a fan brush like this, or I'll use this one. She's kind of fat, but I use one of the two. But it's so much easier to control something with a more dense brush versus a flat highlighting brush. It moves around a lot, but yeah, I really like this because like I said, since the brushes are so dense and together, it moves around. Of course it moves around, any brush should move around, but you have more control. I totally feel like you have more control, like to get it right there on the bridge of your nose and stuff like that. And you could get right there and see your brow bone for those of you that like to put highlighter in your brow bone. And yeah, that's the two brushes that I got. I was waiting to take this out of the freaking packaging because I wanted to open it with you guys, but now I could just put it in my makeup cups, my cup holders, I mean my brush holders, cups, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, I have these two. I got them from Five Below, but I think I've seen them in other places, like the same kind of like glass, and they say cute things on them. So my eyes, this is all my eye brushes, they say you're like really pretty in gold. And then my face brush cup says girls do it better in rose gold. My whole makeup collection, like for my organizers and stuff like that, my make the stuff that holds my makeup, it's all like white, gold, and rose gold, because I'm a girly girl. And yeah, for the exciting part, like I said, we're gonna hop right into the Bretman Rock X Wet n Wild palette, the Jungle Rock palette. It comes with,
oh hell no,
15 shades, and it consists of mattes and shimmers. So let's get right into this. I have yet to like take off this plastic thing on top, and I've had this for a few days already. I got it last week, but I did want to make a video on it, and I wanted to do all that in front of you guys. So yeah, it has like the two tapes that are adhering to the palette, so we're just gonna rip that off so we can swatch. We're swatching here, baby. Okay, plastic is off. Okay, and this is the palette, guys. So pretty. I'm trying to think. Yeah, you could, I think you could use this for everyday looks. You could totally use like the first row besides this one, and that might be too bright. Okay, so like those three shades, like you could totally use that for like an everyday look, and also the brown. But yeah, we're gonna talk about the names, we're gonna talk about the shades, we're gonna swatch them as we go along, and let's do the thing. Oh, and by the way, guys, I got a tattoo. Yeah, it's a butterfly, and it says, "She taught me to fly." It's kind of crusty right now because it's healing, but it says, "She taught me to fly." My mom got the same exact butterfly, and hers says, "I gave her wings," and then mine finishes in, it says, "She taught me to fly." So yeah, we got a little matching tattoo. Ugh, why am I all up in my hair? I'm just trying to, I don't know why. I just washed my hair yesterday. It feels mad oily, and I think it's because my hair mask, it kind of, I guess it like moisturized it too much. I don't know. Whatever. So, first one is called, it's called that, okay? Coconut, well, that word, okay? Because I don't know how to say that word. I'm going to butcher the fuck out of it. Coconut. Coconut connoisseur. I swear I'm not illiterate, but I don't know how to say that word. Anyway, we're gonna swatch it. It's like a super like beige, I feel like it has like a gray undertone to it, but we're gonna swatch her. Oh, they feel nice, they feel like creamy. It looks super white, goddamn. That's her. And I don't know why it looks like a shimmer. It's not a shimmer. It's totally a matte. But yeah, that's her. Oh, why is it like, it looks like a little pinky when I swatched it. Could be my eyeballs. But yeah, that's Coconut Connoisseur. Anyway, next shade we have Prowl. It's a shimmer gold. That's it. Oh, I like that. Pretty, super cute. Next we have Liar and a Cheetah. It's another shimmer. It's like a purple pink. Whoa, it looks super orangey. That's wild. It looks mad orange, and it doesn't look orange like that in the palette, which is really weird, but it is what it is. That's, it is what it is. If you know, you know. TikTok, if you know, you know. Anyway, Yeah, some palettes are like that. Some shades and palettes are like that, where they look a certain way in the pan, and then once you swatch it or once you use it, it's like a completely different, not completely different, but like not what you expected. It might have like a different undertone to it, or it just totally doesn't look like what it looks like inside of the pan, and that's normal. It happens. It probably has to do, you know what? No, I don't know. I ain't trying to get professional, y'all, because I don't even know what that means. I don't know why that happens, but it happens. It's normal. It happens to me with other palettes that I've used in the past. So, next shade is Don't Be Lying. Don't Be Lying. Not lying. Don't Be Lying. Okay. And that is also a shimmer, but it's not as shimmery as the ones that I've swatched so far. There you go, that's Don't Be Lying right there. Ooh, these shades right here all together look really pretty. Right. Next, we have King of the Jungle. It's like a super yellow shimmer. And I might be bugging, but it looks a little green to me. Maybe it's because it's so yellow. It looks like a super lime, like super bright neon yellow. I mean, green. Oh, but I'm wrong, because that's definitely, oh, that's a yellow as fuck. Yellow. It's pretty. I like this. That would be nice, like, you know when people do, like, they don't really do, like, an eye look. They maybe put, like, a wing liner, but they'll put, like, a color in their tear duct on the inner corner. I feel like that would be such a pretty color for, like, the summer. That would be super cute. Let me get a makeup wipe. How do you guys like it so far? Comment down below if you like the palette so far. Do y'all like Bretman Rock? I love Bretman Rock. He's Bretman. The sign is beach, 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 beach. I showed him to my mom recently when I actually got the palette. I showed her who he was. Cause I was with her when I got it, and I showed her, and she was weak, bro. He's great. Okay. Next row. We're on Anaconda. Don't mind my nails. Anaconda. It's like a turquoise color, and that's a matte shade. That's her. Oh, she's cute. Okay. That was a little underwhelming. Little underwhelming. Maybe with like a good base, it'll reach like its full potential, but like that was really underwhelming if you ask me. Whatever. Next shade is Venomous. It's the shade right next to Anaconda, and it's another like turquoisey shade, but I feel like it has more green to it for sure. It's so weird. The consistency is weird. Like, I don't know how to explain it. I don't know if it's because I become so used to like a high-end makeup, could be. That's it. I think I'm doing a good job at swatching it. It's a little patchy. Like I said, I feel like you can't really judge makeup, I mean eyeshadows, without like a nice, like a good base, you know? So that's obviously once you like, actually use it as like an eye look or whatever, and you prime your eyes with concealer or like an eye primer, that it would probably like reach its full potential. But like those past two shades were very underwhelming for me. But moving on, we have Flamingo, the purple color, fuchsia color, whatever. This is she. Oh, this is cute. That's her right there. Why am I going on an angle? It's like, it doesn't look like I'm going on an angle when I'm looking like this, but when I put it up, it looks like it's on an angle. Whatever. But yeah, that's it. Flamingo. I like it. It's cute. It's super him, and I love it. Next we have Pounce On Him, which is that red color. I think he said in his video that it does stain your eyes. I think I seen when like he reviewed it, like not reviewed it, revealed it or whatever the fuck it was. Anyways, he said that one of these colors stains the eyes, that to not be worried. So I just thought I'd let you guys know that too. Okay, this is nice. I like this. Orange. It's like a, no, it's red, but like it's like a bright red. It's like a hot red. Cute. That, yeah, pounce on them, pounce on them, pounce on them, pounce on them, pounce on them. Okay. Next, we have Ape Shit, which is a dark brown color right here. I feel like it's a lot dark. Okay, there you go. I feel like when I got closer, you could tell how dark it was, because from here, it looks light, and you can tell how dark it is. Next, yeah, Ape Shit. It's a matte. Also, all the shades since I've started this row, from Anaconda all the way to this color right here, Ape Shit, they were all matte shades, which you obviously can tell. Typical brown is cute. Closer, it is darker. Oh my god, I'm going on an angle. I thought going this way would make it easier to show the camera, and I actually have to go the opposite way. What a loser. Okay. Next, we're going into the last row, into the shade Deeper. It is a shimmer blue shade. I'm trying to debate if I should start doing, yeah, I'm gonna start doing my wrist. Deeper. Oh, it feels nice and it looks nice. Oh, I like this. I like that. That's cute. I really want to see how these shades look on a good base. I really do. Next, we have Big Peacock Energy, a shimmer green. I've never seen a green shimmer like this green color. It's like a forest green. I've seen like light greens shimmers, but this I haven't seen before. I like this. Ooh, this might be the best shade on the palette. Super, oh no. Oh no. Do y'all wanna see? I mean, I'm gonna show you guys, but kind of disappointed. Please look at the shade. You see how bright and green, not bright, but like you can tell it's like really green. And look at how it transferred onto my wrists. It looks very, it looks black. It looks like black with like green glitter. I don't know how I feel about that. Damn, this palette is kind of disappointing me, guys. I'm not gonna lie. Don't attack me though. Don't attack me in the comments if you're a Bretman Rock fan, because I'm a Bretman Rock fan and I expected this to be amazing. But I feel like you also have to understand that this is, that Wet n Wild is not, it's a drugstore brand. And I'm not knocking drugstore brands, obviously. When you start, usually, typically, you use drugstore brand. And I use drugstore brand stuff. Like, NYX foundation, Maybelline Fit Me powder, NYX lip gloss, you fucking name it. I have e.l.f. primer. These are all drugstore brands. But typically, my eyeshadow palettes are not drugstore brands. They are usually high end, like Morphe, Kylie Cosmetics. Me trying to find my other palettes. Why can't I think? Anyways, oh, Anastasia Beverly Hills. I don't know. I just really couldn't think of any that I have, but I have a lot. And yeah, so like usually my eyeshadows that I use are high end, so I guess this is why I'm like but like it's definitely, you can work with it, you know. It's like I said, you can't really, I feel like you can't really judge eyeshadows unless you have a good base, and I'm using my arm with no base, no primer. So, but I know this shade is not gonna look any different when I use a concealer or a eyeshadow primer. That kind of made me upset, and you all heard me. I was just like, this might be my favorite shade in the palette, and it's not my favorite shade in the palette. I don't know what my favorite shade in the palette is yet. I think I know, but all right, we're gonna keep going. Next, we have this purple matte shade. It's called Feline Myself. Instead of feeling myself, it's feline because this is like jungle. So feline, cat, you get it, right? A purple matte. And they feel super chalky. Oh, but I like you. Yep, I like you, sis. We friends. I like you. Look at that, guys. I like that. I do. That's a nice color. I can't wait to use this on like a real look instead of just swatching. It's gotta be better. I won't allow for it to be shit, okay? Next, Toucan Play That Game. So instead of Toucan Play That Game, it's Toucan, like the bird. And it's like this burgundy shade right here. Toucan Play That Game. It's a matte. That's one thing I will say. The mattes aren't creamy. And I'm used to like creamy mattes. But this, like, they feel like chalky. Oh, this might be the shade that he said stains. But yeah, it's like, oh, we can compare. That's the red from before. This one right here. And then this is this one. It's darker, definitely darker. And yeah. Oh, I think this is when he said that stains. Alrighty. Next, we have the last shade is Alpha. It's black with shimmer in it. You can see there's shimmer in it. Let's see how this swatches. It has like gold. I don't know if you could tell. It's gold. Oh yeah, you can. It has gold shimmer in it. Not you can't really tell on the, like, when I swatch it. Like, it, you can't tell on the camera, but like I can see it that it is shimmery and not just a plain black matte shade. But that, you, I would consider that's a matte shade. It just has specks of gold glitter in it. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm really not a fan of it. Like, I wouldn't, I mean, it's not a total L because, like I said, you have to try it with a good base. It's not a total L. If this was any more than what it was, like the money, I wouldn't have gone out of my way if I knew that they looked like this. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, so me telling you guys, if you got the 15 bucks to just throw around, go for it, you know? Just to have it, just to, yeah, you know, just add an extra palette to your collection. But if I'm being honest, if it was more than $15, if it reached like that $20 range, I wouldn't have gone out of my way to get this palette. Well, I'm telling you guys to not go out of your way to get this palette if you're not willing to spend, if you weren't willing to spend like $20+, if it were $20+, you get what I'm saying? I don't want to cause any confusion. But yeah, I'm very, very, very upset that this turned out this way. I'm not even gonna lie. I had such high hopes. And obviously, like, Bretman himself, he's gonna, since it's his palette, you know, and he's up on his channel, he's gonna talk very good about it, which is what he should be doing, you know. That's how you promote stuff. You should be talking good about your stuff, you know. But yeah, like I said, I think I love the brushes. I love the brushes 100%. They did what they had to do with the brushes. Yeah. These bangers, these are good. I like these. If there's one thing I would tell you to spend your money on, it's the brushes. And that, honestly, is because Wet n Wild is always known for their good brush, their cheap good brushes. These are really, 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 really good. They're just regular Wet n Wild. Like, I don't know if y'all know this, I'm pretty sure y'all know this. Like, whenever a celebrity or an influencer collabs with a big makeup brand and they come out with brush sets, they're not creating new brushes. It's just a remake of brushes that this brand already has. Correct me if I'm wrong. But I'm pretty sure I'm right. But, like, for example, like when James Charles collabed with Morphe, or Jaclyn Hill collabs with Morphe, or Jeffree Star collabs with Morphe, they're all brushes that have been out, but they make it their own. And yeah, that's basically what this is, because you know the regular Wet n Wild brushes are typically white with like white bristles, and then the tips are pink. Basically what they did was make it his own, like that's what he did, so it could fit with the collection. And yeah, if there's one thing I would tell you guys to spend your money on, it is the brushes. Okay, so that's basically all I gotta say about this collection. Do I hate it? No. If I had to give it a rating, scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the worst, 10 being the best, I would probably give this collection like a 7. Okay, a 7, because like I said, the brushes are amazing. The brush is 10 out of 10, but the palette, I expected better. But like I said, you can't really you have to think about how much you're paying for this, you know. So if it's like not the best, it is what it is. I don't really know what else to say. I was gonna tag him in this video, but I want to see it. I'm not dragging you, okay? I'm not. I want to see him do a big collab. I want to see him collab with Morphe. I think he has a Morphe collab, but it's not an eyeshadow pack. You know what? Don't even quote me on that. I need to come out with like a bomb ass, like, he deserves an Anastasia collab, okay? Like these big people do, like Emrezi or Carly Bible, I don't fucking know. Jackie Aina. Like, I think Bretman Rock is at that level, and he deserves a collab from ABH. So y'all need to go on ABH's platform, social media platforms, and let them know, collab with Bretman, because and if he doesn't already have like a bomb ass palette with Morphe, I think he has something with Morphe. I think it's a highlighting palette, so it's not an eyeshadow palette. He needs to come out with a bomb ass eyeshadow palette with Morphe, because I promise you this shit would be fire, bro. Because imagine all these shades, but like 10 times better quality, you know? Like, it has nothing to do with the shade. I think the shades are beautiful. It goes with the theme that he was going for, the jungle theme. It's just the quality of the eyeshadow, and that has nothing to do with him. It has to do with the brand itself, and it's a drugstore brand. Like I was saying, I don't need to sound repetitive, but it's true. It's a drugstore brand. You can't expect to get Tarte quality eyeshadows when you're paying $15 for a palette. I mean, would it be great? Sure. And I'm sure there's palettes out there like that. There are palettes out there like that, that they're dirt cheap and they have quality of like Tarte and Urban Decay and shit like that. But if we're being honest, Urban Decay's eyeshadows aren't that good. Anyways, yeah, be spending like 50 something bucks on the Naked palettes and trash, garbage, because you could get those shades and cheaper, like Morphe palettes. But that's none of my business. Alright, so I'm gonna end this video here, guys. I wanted to let you guys know, do you guys want a part 2 to the last video that I made? It was a quarantine shopping haul. I could totally make a part 2, because my fingers is tapping screens, my fingers is tapping checkouts, my fingers is tapping at the shopping cart. My thumb is hitting double click on my lock button for Apple Pay, and it's out of control. I'm not gonna sit here and lie to you guys, it's out of control. But let's just say I've purchased enough stuff to make another video, okay? It might be even more stuff than what I did last time. So if y'all are willing to see another video, let me know in the comments, okay? It's been real, guys. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Catch me on your phone screen, catch me on your TV screen, catch me on your laptop, catch me on your flip phone. Catch me there, because I'm gonna be there. It's been real, guys. Bye. Love you.